Hey, Lakeshore family, it's Kelli, and I'm here on a Friday to share some words of encouragement to you about being a bold, confident disciple of Christ. It's something that I struggle with myself, and so I have a few words, hopefully, that will speak to you as well. So a couple of weeks ago, I was talking to my family, who I love dearly, dearly, and I was telling them how awkward and incompetent I feel speaking in public, that this position as minister is new to me, and I don't feel confident yet in the way that I present myself. And so as I'm talking to my family, my mom and dad, precious people, reminded me that I had been equipped for this and that there was nobody better than me. And of course, that's a proud parent's point of view. Nobody's better than their kid. But it made me feel better knowing that, you know, my parents believed in me and believed that they thought that I could do it. And then Caitlin spoke up. And if you know Caitlin, you know, sometimes she doesn't always think before she speaks. And her input was, "Yeah, Mom, there's no one worse than you." Of course, she didn't mean that the way that, you know, that it sounded. And we gave her a really hard time about it, and we laughed about it. But I realized something in what she said to me, and I realized that she was right. So as I'm struggling with trying to come up with what I'm going to talk about for my video, I realized that this is the perfect topic for me. We don't have to be perfect and great at anything. We just have to be willing, because we are equipped with the power of the Holy Spirit. If you read in Acts 1:8, it says, "You will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you shall be my witnesses both in Jerusalem and all Judea and Samaria and even to the remotest part of the earth." So if we are servants of the Lord, then we have the power of the Holy Spirit within us. Think about that. The Holy Spirit, who raised Jesus from the dead, who created heavens and earth, who gives the breath of life, is the same Spirit that commands all of us to be witnesses for Him. And with that, He equips us for God's will and purpose. So sometimes, especially me, it's really easy to make excuses. "Well, I can't do this, Lord, because I'm too old, I'm too poor, I'm too young, I'm not physically able or mentally able, or I'm not gifted at this, or I'm not outgoing." In my case, it's, "I'm not a good public speaker," or "I'm not a leader," or "I'm not creative." We make excuses because we feel insecure. We're stubborn. We want to be comfortable. We are resistant to opening ourselves up, and we let that keep us from really submitting to God and being His willing disciple. But being a disciple doesn't mean that there are exceptions. It's a commandment, and it's a commandment for everyone, despite what we think are our imperfections or insecurities. One person in the Bible who really stands out to me is Moses. In the book of Exodus, he told God, he said, "I'm not eloquent of speech." And I really make a connection with Moses, because I feel like I am not eloquent, you know, with my speech when I speak in public. And multiple times, Moses says, "I can't do this, I can't do this." But God equipped him for a purpose. And that purpose was to lead the Israelites out of their bondage in Egypt. But God equipped him for that purpose. Even if he saw himself as not eloquent, God equipped him for that purpose. And there are countless other examples in the Bible of people that are used for God's purpose, despite having no money, despite having little education besides having a physical inability, or they lacked youthfulness, or they lacked wisdom. God has a plan for every single one of us. And if he has a plan for them, then he certainly has one for us, despite what we think our failures are. In Matthew 28:19, is everybody probably knows this. This is a great commission, but it says, we are commanded to go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, them to observe all that I have commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. There is no exception in there. It doesn't say, if you are. It says, go. Much like Moses, he will equip us for the work that he has for us. He empowers us, and he empowers us to go and make. One other verse that's encouraging to me is in Ephesians 3. Paul tells us that the power of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit are all that we need to have boldness and confidence. We just have to be willing, and then we will be equipped with that Spirit to do his purposes. So as I'm still learning and still new to some of these things, and I feel very insecure at my lack of eloquence in public, these words are encouragement to me to know that the Holy Spirit has empowered me to go and make disciples of kids. And so one thing that I want to reassure you is, when you feel insecure, or you feel lowly or insignificant, or you don't feel competent, remember, if you are a believer, you are sealed with the Holy Spirit. So you can be confident that the work that he started in you, he will perfect until he returns. So we just need to be willing, and we'll work. All the work is a work in progress. Have a great weekend.